Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Mark Braund, who is the chairman of REAT PLC. Mark, it's great to have you on the line. And before we delve into your latest results, I'd like to start by asking if you could just get us up to speed with what it is the company does.
Certainly. Good morning, Tom. REAT Group, we're a specialist cleaning and decontamination business. We deep clean premises, properties that are quite important, such as hospitals, rail carriages, restaurants. We also get involved in clearing up after road traffic accidents. We do a lot of work on fatalities and animal strikes, unfortunately, on the railways. We'll clean up prison cells and deal with void properties. And we have some other specialist FM services. We clean schools and health clinics and manufacturing sites. So a little bit more specific or special than, you know, straightforward janitorial cleaning. And of course, in May of last year, we acquired one of the UK's largest commercial window cleaning businesses, which was fairly fundamental part of our ongoing strategy.
Understood. Yes, I'm keen to touch on that. But before we do, I would like to ask how it is that you got into this particular space, because it's a very specific type of a business, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, are you referring to the company or me personally? Because there's a story for both. I mean, if I just quickly answer both, actually, me personally, people may recognize me as having been involved in tech business and professional services. But I would like to add that my first job as a salesman nearly 40 years ago was actually working for OCS, Office Cleaning Services, at the very beginning of the era of sort of FM services. So I've kind of come full circle. But in terms of how the business started, it was actually the very core of the business was reactive emergency services, the bit that I said at the very beginning, where we're, you know, deep cleaning things and clearing up after some fairly ugly incidents. That was part of a privately held company called AutoCleanse. And AutoCleanse didn't see it fit, and therefore sprang it out into what we see now, into a PLC. And unfortunately, it had a fairly torrid time because it really wasn't fit for purpose in terms of its management and the way in which it was operating. The services that it delivered were in demand and customers loved it, but the management processes just really didn't work. I got involved because investors were disappointed. The revenues were about 3.5 million. It'd been regularly losing money. The year I came involved, became involved, it was losing just over £600,000. So that's where it all started. And we've taken on a journey over the last 3 or 4 years. I've got a fantastic management team. Sean Doak, the first time CEO, has worked wonders to grow the business organically. And Andrea has worked wonders to help the processes become much more fit for purpose. She's the CFO.
Thanks, Mark. Well, that leads us very nicely into the latest set of results, doesn't it? And it does sound like you've managed to turn things around. A lot of growth in there.
Yeah, I mean, I mentioned earlier, Sean, he comes from a sales background, very much like myself. Organic growth has been part of this mission for the last 3 years. This isn't the first year we've grown organically. We've been growing every year since Sean got involved. 17% organic growth, 78% overall after the acquisition. The acquisition we can talk about separately, but the organic growth in a year where, as a small company, we were also brought in an acquisition, a fundraise, and a few other bits and pieces, was quite remarkable. And I think we can better that in the years to come. It is a turnaround over the last 3 or 4 years. There is more energy there to deliver even better in the years to come.
So let's look at Ladders Free now. So what prompted that particular acquisition, and what has it done for the business?
Well, our strategy has been to recognize that the original core business was very project orientated. So every time you won a piece of business, you had to go and find another piece. So, clearly the rules of business are you need to have a recurring stream of business in order to provide a level of predictability going forward and to become attractive as an investment proposition. So that's what we set out to do, not only fix the company, get our margins in the right position and get it operationally efficient. We wanted to grow out the recurring revenue nature of what we do, and that was feasible. We started that and won some contracts within the group, but then we made the acquisition of Fidelis, which is a soft services FM business, slightly lower margins, but cleaning schools and health clinics and the likes. And that brought a major step forward in terms of recurring revenue. A lot of the contracts are 5 to 7 years in length. So good, resilient business in resilient markets. That is free as a recurring revenue business, almost entirely. It's all contracted. They're quite unique in that they are one of the largest, but they're still a relatively small company. And that's because the market is so fragmented. And that's the key here. You know, people think of large cleaning companies, and they might think of OCS, ISS, Mighty, people like that. But actually, whilst those companies may do your sort of, you know, generic, janitorial cleaning, when it comes to something specific or special, they call on companies like ours. And there are literally thousands of them that do this kind of work. What we've done is we've now consolidated a sequence of services into one platform, our platform, and we're able to deliver a consistently high level of quality standard across the UK, anywhere in the UK, and at a price that is often unbeatable, because the cost of actually putting together multiple companies to do that, even if it's under a large FM banner, can be significantly higher than we can operate at, and still make a very healthy margin. So Ladders Free was a perfect fit. It also fit for a couple of other reasons. About 85 to 86% of its business is either with large nationwide customers, of which there are 22, or with about 30 smaller FM businesses. The rest, about 15, 14%, is regional companies that just, you know, called upon Ladders Free to do the work. Ladders Free have had no churn of customers in the last 5 years in that 86% I just mentioned, the nationwide and the FM businesses. And that's because they're very, very, you know, very unique in how they deliver. It's a capital, working capital light business model in that they've built a membership of businesses that deliver the services for them. They've trained them, they audit them, and then they find them their work. And that work is delivered locally to the customers. And that's where the nationwide capability at a fairly low cost model comes in. So for us, that was very attractive. And not only attractive as a standalone, but also as a channel to market and a channel for services for some of the other services we deliver. And I guess that's best exemplified by the contract win we announced on the 4th or 5th of January, where we have brought all the services of the group together to deliver a deep cleaning capability to one of the UK's best known fast food service outlets. 350 of their locations nationwide. We're cleaning the fascias, the windows, sparkle cleaning them. We're doing the inside front, inside back twice a year to make sure they meet their hygiene standards. And that's a couple of year contract. And that was one of Ladders Free's customers. So it's just an example. And if you think about the prospect universe outside the 22 companies we service that way, it's enormous. And that's really our target market for the future.
Understood. Well, I do just have one final question for you very briefly, Mark, which is, what do you think people can expect from the business during the rest of this calendar year?
Well, we have broker forecasts out there. Singers are our Singers Capital Markets are our brokers. And you can expect to see, continued organic growth. And you can expect to see now a leverage on the operational capability of the business to provide, significantly improved profitability.
Simple as that. Mark Braund, yeah. Thank you very much for coming to talk to us at Proactive today.
Thank you very much yourself, Tom. Thank you. Bye-bye.